Congrats! You made it to the final chapter of Basic JavaScript. We boarded the journey together and have come this far, starting from variables, to if, else, to loops. It has been quite a progressive journey. Let's go ahead and learn one last topic. Shall we? Let's say we want to create a program which will print the result of addition of two numbers. We would create two variables to hold the values of two numbers and another variable which will hold the value of the addition of the numbers. Followed by printing the third variable as follows. What if we've to calculate the results of several combinations like 1 and 2, 4 and 5, 6 and 7. Then creating a new variable every time and adding it in the third variable would be a lot of work to do. Right? What if I tell you that there's a way to just write the code once and use it for any combination of numbers? That is, to write reusable code which could be used anywhere in the program. The term we're looking for is called functions. Let's learn about it. A function is a block of reusable code which can be used anywhere in the program. The main aim of a function is to eliminate the need of writing the same code again and again. Like if we can create a function which would perform addition, and we can call it several times to perform the same task rather than writing separate codes whenever we want to perform addition. Now that we know what a function is, let's go ahead and learn how to create one. A function can only be used when it is called. Until and unless we call the function which adds numbers, the function will sit ideally being jobless. Tongue. So the first step is function definition, which basically means to define the function, i.e. to create a function. Once we're done defining the function, the next step is to call and use it. Don't worry, we will learn each and every step. Let's start with the first one. A function can be defined in the following way. We start defining the function by using the function keyword followed by the name of the function, which is then followed by open and close round brackets. Once we're done with it, let's create a function which prints I know JavaScript. A function can be defined in the following way. We start defining the function by using the function keyword followed by the name of the function which is then followed by open and close round brackets. Once we're done with it, we write the reusable code inside the curly brackets. Let's create a function which prints I know JavaScript. We'll start by writing the function keyword followed by naming the function and opening and closing the round brackets. We've named our function as print. Once we're done with that, let's write the code to print inside curly brackets. Yes, we're done with the function definition. Let's move on to calling the function. Now, we have a function named print which prints I know JavaScript. The next step is calling that function. Calling a function is as easy as writing the name of the function followed by opening and closing round brackets. So, the whole code would look something like. Let's build up on the addition function. We'll create a function followed by declaring two variables and then performing addition in the third variable and finally printing it out. Finally, we will call the function. Right? As we had mentioned earlier, the main aim of function was to make the code reusable. So how do we put in different values in the function so that it will print the result? The solution to that is parameters. Parameters are passed while calling the functions and later those passed parameter can be manipulated inside the functions. That is, let's say we pass 2 and 3 in our add function while calling it, then inside the function we can use the pass parameters i.e. 2 and 3 to perform their addition and hence printing it out. Similarly, we can pass 4 and 5 as a parameter to that function and hence printing the result. Thus becoming successful in making our function reusable. Let's write a program to get a clear picture of the same. Let's create a function to add two numbers. Let's start by creating a function. Now, since we are going to call this function using parameters, thus we've to mention it while creating the function. This is how we do it. Here, num1 and num2 are the two numbers we'll get as parameters while the function is called. Now let's go ahead and create a variable which would store the value of the end result. We're ready to call the function. In this scenario, we're passing 3 and 4 as parameters to the function. So num1 becomes 3 and num2 becomes 4, and hence the result variable stores the result and prints it out. And this is the end of this course. But not the end of learning. I hope we've done our job to fullest. And motivated you enough to explore advanced JavaScript.